In the days leading up to this debate, I was talking to both men and women about the issue that we are debating about today. It was very interesting to see the different reactions. Men were very often, or actually most of them, annoyed, confused, or ridiculed the issue a little bit, whereas women were very excited and actually really wanted this issue to be debated upon. I think that this symbolizes one of the core issues that feminism is facing nowadays in the Western world. Because if men do not identify with the term feminism and the ideas behind it, there is a big issue we have in communicating our goals as women. The interesting thing, however, is that most people in Western society actually do agree on the equality of sexes, but that for some reason the term feminism seems to be so alienating that people do not want to identify with it. I was actually quite convinced that Emma Watson, during her speech at the UN, which you can see under this link, was highly successful in addressing the issue and conveying it to a broader audience. Because we can no longer have this debate about feminism and its goals within a female elitist circle. It can no longer be just among women of academic background who read a lot of issues and papers and books on this topic. Instead, it finally has to address men and put them at the forefront of this debate, because men are the ones who finally have to challenge the role stereotypes that still persist in the private sphere. Up until today, girls grow up with very different role models. They are still educated in a different way. They, in relationships, still fulfill a different role. In a marriage, they still take up most of the household work. This is exactly the area that feminism so far failed to tackle, and I believe that it fails to address this issue because it excludes men from the debate. If we seriously want to tackle the core problem of this issue, which is how young girls grow up, we have to include men, and men need to become the spokespeople of this issue and this movement. Fathers, uncles, brothers, and cousins finally need to start changing their perception of girls when raising them. I believe that the private sector is the one we need to focus on so much, because everything else regarding the workforce or the sexuality or healthcare benefits is already pretty much equalized. I agree there are still issues with regards to wage differences, but these, I think, will even out over the next years as more and more women start finishing university and graduate and start working in high professions. It is, however, still this private sphere which is so exclusive, and therefore celebrities like Emma Watson and other people are the characters that can convey this message to broader masses. We can no longer have this debate to be so exclusive among women. It has to finally branch out to the majority of society, since especially the majority of the society supports its goals. Therefore, men can no longer be felt detached from the debate or even excluded. They finally need to be addressed in a very direct manner, but without accusations, but more as an invitation. We therefore have to embrace and congratulate people like Emma Watson and other celebrities. I'm not saying that this debate should solely be done by celebrities, but they are definitely a great stakeholder in conveying this debate to the broad majority of society, and this should be our goal if we truly want to overcome female stereotypes and role models that girls grow up with up until today. You're already recording? Oh.
Play that soul.
I wish I was a little bit taller, so every time I step into the record store, I wouldn't have to holler. Excuse me, I'm sorry, I'm only 5'6". Got the bricks for the fix to raise me up an inch. I can see the Whitney records from here. They're in my view. If you could help me for a second,
I will always love you.
She's my girl. Oh wait, was that CCR too? Man, go back up the ladder. I'm about to revive. They call me proud.